And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity. Blind. We are about to head down into the mines off the Great Hall of Durgan's Battery itself. So down we go. There are also stairs heading upward. But since we found ourselves right in front of these stairs, we'll try this first. Ooh, interesting. I found a level that appears to have been a mining hub at one point. Like the rest of Durgan's Battery, it looks deserted now, so I'll have to keep searching. We will do that.
No problem.
Glad to hear it. If there was a problem, though, that would be a problem. No secrets? Nothing to scavenge from these? Someone's riding the minecart, and that doesn't sound like they're having a very good time.
We can't hold them off!
Fall back!
As she runs forward. You missed. Oh boy. And that's where we came from. Okay. Seems to be a rather big level. Hello. Heat ripples and rises from great covered hallways below you. And stuff waits to be attacked. We will oblige it. With them. A battery siren? Oh boy. It's gonna beguile our senses, isn't she? My god. These things mean business. She's attacking Theodas. Well, the battery defender actually is. Ouch. We can't knock them, right? I mean, we could try. I think these we can. Stuff like this, spirits, we can't. Makes sense, though. Bounding missiles. Hit multiple foes. Oh, let's do that blast thing. Boom. Maybe it'll knock them down, too. That'd be great. Jeez, they're running all over. They hit that one. Oh, jeez, I'll get knocked down. What if you feel like doing there, Devil of Karak? It's fine with me. Aloth getting into the thick of it. So, ever since we gave him the staff, he's really reckless. Blessing. Alright, finish this thing off. Exploded. I'm like, oh my god, there's others. They're firing projectiles from over there. Great. So we're flanked by these things. I need some major healing here. Out of focus. Oh, song just stopped. Yeah, just go like that and then do this. Belay those orders. Did he? He missed her because she moved. Damn it. Are we within range of these things? Oh my god, we're paralyzed and stuff. Who's not paralyzed? Stuck. We all are. Except for Theodas. What can she do? Not much. I want to hit more than just one. Can we charm this guy?
Kind of stuck.
Immune. Great. Are we, like, not... Some of us are unparalyzed. Yeah, I need some help here. Paralyzed. Lay hands.
Kind of...
Reviving exhortation, Devil Karras. Welcome back. I don't think those guys can reach us now. Yay! Yep, no. Oh my god, were they here, the same ones? And they came around? That's pretty cool. How'd you like getting up close and personal?
What? Owen.
Hey.
Well, he can't reach. Damn it. Don't know if Kara can knock him down, though. Oh, can we let Aelath kill it?
How may I help?
Oh, he's winding that thing up. Come on, keep winding it. Nice. Why does this randomly come up, Stormcaller? To remind us to use it, because I haven't been using it. I know, I'm trying to focus on Aelath's weapon right now. This is why we're doing this. We're trying to kill 25 enemies. He doesn't seem to be able to successfully hit the blight, so we're going for regular enemies. So he's got 9 more to go. And then we'll unlock the next level. Whichever level that is.
Sure.
Is that? Wait. Where'd that bracelet go? saw a bracelet. Actually, I have no idea then. Okay. Right, so they're not over there now. They moved.
Good thing I'm freshly greased.
That sounds kind of suggestive there, Devil of Carrick.
They're coming! To the mines!
I am very thirsty at the moment. Workshop. We'll open that in a little bit.
Losing ground!
Is that so?
They're coming over the barricade!
Is that what you call this? The wall has been smashed into great jagged shards. Exceptional morning star and a potion of major endurance.
It's a fine touch. Really opens up the hall.
She's awesome. Skeletons lie crushed beneath enormous stone slabs.
How may I help?
Only a few bones protrude from the rubble, and they've been broken like twigs.
I shall.
Yeah, big slabs hurt, you know. Big owie. These won't attack? They probably eventually will.
Fight!
Yeah, it didn't take that long. Knock that one down. Knock that one down. That one. Chain lightning on the one who likes to fight. Knock down a Palagina there. Got them all? Yep. That went too fast. He's kind of doing knockdown on things that are already knocked down. An Aeloth here. Chain lightning.
Lavaru, be on seat.
Fun. Guys aren't too tough, though. Guys.
What?
Oh, that one's dead. Pathing's a little messed up here.
Hey.
That was pretty easy. Oh, I'm holding shift. I don't want that. Who took it? Hold on a second. Okay. Looking for any special items, and there's none. I don't really expect them. These guys are really easy. That's what I picked up before. Where'd it go, though? Couldn't find it after. Durgan copper bracelet? Though Durgan's battery is mostly known for its steel, the refineries also produced extremely high-quality copper that was used in coinage, art, and jewelry. This copper bracelet is typical of the jewelry that was produced in the community at its height. Going into stash. Someone keeps screaming over and over again. This is a really long haul. Look how, yeah. It goes through the whole, diagonally through this whole freaking mine, I guess. I wonder if a mine cart would run along here. I mean, not anymore with this crap in the way, but...
I shall be discreet.
Got it.
There's nothing here. I was gonna look at this. Many of these bones have been ground into grit. The breastplates and cuisses are all smashed or bent beyond further use. Sorry guys, some of these words I don't know. And I really used in today's society. These stone slabs have shattered like pottery. Ooh, look at that. A heavy bronze suit appears to have been ripped apart, its pieces scattered across the floor. Okay, the whole thing can... No, I guess we can't do anything with that. The whole thing highlights, though. It's weird. To seek the White Forge in the north. Ooh.
Let us in! They're coming!
You hear me drinking, guys? I'm very, very thirsty. Taking every advantage I can. Same thing. Scattered and ripped across the floor, blah blah blah. A door. Well, this is odd. It doesn't end, it just fades into darkness. It's weird. Let's see if we can get in. Reached Old Valia in the west. A cold wind from the south. And bore our parents east. So it goes in that order, I guess. North, west, south, east. Do that here. As you approach the door, you notice the round depression within the surrounding frame. The molding around the depression is elaborately carved with a row of foreign symbols lining the topmost edge of the circle. What'd I say? North, west, south, east? I'm not even sure. The depression is about 3 finger-widths deep, with a few small stone fragments jutting out from within the wall. Excuse me. Some pieces seem to rotate independently along slots, but they have no obvious effect in and of themselves. Hmm. So we need something to put in that. The door leading down appears to be sealed, but there's some kind of stone socket next to it. Alright, we need to find something to put in that, obviously. Oh, sneaky. We'll go through here. Open doorway. Another door. Hmm, hear a lot of sounds coming from this door.
A simple test.
blasphemy.
Oh, really? How's that? Reveal unto me your blasphemy. Despite the years of weathering, where the helmets on the other armors in the room are plain and lustreless, this one is brighter and more reflective. Okay, that's a secret something that opens something. This armor has been posed bracing behind a broad shield, thick and sturdy as a city gate. Here's another hidden thingy. The sword wielded by this suit of armor is covered in fine detail work, far more intricate than that of the armor itself. Ooh. Look at that. It's like floating, propelled by lightning, to float in the air above this thing. Do we dare? What's this? A hole bores into the stone. Its edges are blackened and gritty with soot. Oh. Nightshroud. Oh, it's a spellbound mace. We're in the Hall of Remembrance, by the way. I just noticed that. Killed three Shingula with the Nightshroud to unlock the next level. Binds with a rogue or priest. Ooh. Oh, I think I'm going to give this to our rogue. It's an exceptional weapon and 10% chance to cast blind on hit or critical hit. Shadows ooze and pull around you, filling your mind with memories of furtive expeditions, clandestine meetings, and the traffic of secrets. You hear the whispers of the men and women who snuck, struck, and survived by the power of this weapon. An apprentice smith of the Pargrin was cleaning out the forge room when he saw something glowing in the slag heap. He told his master about it, but the older smith waved him off, assuring the young man that it was merely a hot stone. Undeterred, the apprentice took the glowing stone before carting the rest of the slag away. He kept it in his pocket for the next several days, but the strange glow didn't abate. He snuck into the smithy at night to begin working on the piece, yet he couldn't bring himself to hammer the glowing ore into a blade. Instead, he fashioned a mace. Pretty sure I'm going to give this to Devil of Carrick. Oh, and now we find a trap.
And the fire shows me something new.
Can you undo this, let's say?
Hmm? These are Abidun's treasures!
And this is a trap we can't disarm. Okay.
You can trust me.
Yeah, except when you can't do it. Let's see what we got.
Uh-huh.
Well, it's crushing versus piercing. Doesn't hit for as much. I can't pass up a soulbound weapon, though. Durrance can also use it, but you know what? I'm going to give it to the Devil of Carrick. Because she doesn't have a cool weapon. And she just has a fine spear. Bind. Alright. Any Shingula, we have to attack it. Let her attack. Oh no. Oh. Cast the blinded... Didn't it say we had to kill three Shingula? We have to cast the blinded affliction 13 times with the weapon. Now, she already has a blind spell.
Uh-huh.
She agrees. Oh, that's immortal? Okay, turn that off. Blinding strike. with the... It's called blinding... What is it? Blinded affliction. Cause it. Oh! Hit it? Okay. It casts blind on a hit, a critical hit. 10% chance, so we have to cause it. What happened to the killing three Shangwila things? That's weird.
Sure.
Oh. This thing's got something in its hand now. Was that like that before? A circular depression carved into the stone sits below the relief of a dwarven warrior. The armor-clad figure is charging ahead against an unseen enemy. Inspect the stone carving. Three holes punctuate the bottom of the circular depression. Their edges seem worn, as if something had scraped against them. Above the depression, a dwarf appears to ready a charge, holding a shield low and a sword high. Okay. More things we have to put in things.
Light, flame, and sun.
What? Crap. Ugh. What? Oh, it must have hit her twice. No! Damn it! I have to play this part over. Yeah, I can't accept that. Okay. I'm gonna try something.
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
What?
+3 mechanics. Take one. Oh, what I put in here? Damn it. I'm used to hitting shift to move things around. Where would we find it? There's four of them. Where does this stuff go? It's not going to be in with weapons or armor or that stuff. Ah, okay. Do not put that in there. I want one. Okay, now deactivate it.
Margrin's fire.
Oh, deactivate this.
Air cast light in dark.
No. Don't run into it. Deactivate it.
That's settled. That's settled.
Any more? There's one here.
And the fire shows me something new.
Deactivate that. That. Place is full of traps. Any more?
You profane Abaddon's sake.
Alright, now everyone else run forward because our priest is here by himself. And don't sneak.